Yes, people, and welcome back to AJ Cars, and welcome back to another video on the E92 M3. And today we're going to be talking about the most common issues on these cars and things you need to look out for before you buy one. But before we get into video, I hope you guys are enjoying the content on this car. I'm trying to get as much out there as possible. And if you are, make sure you hit that subscribe button. And if you do enjoy this video, hit that like button as well. And we'll get straight back into the video. So I wouldn't say the E9X M3, whichever one it is, I wouldn't say they're an unreliable car. However, every car has their issues, and this definitely does have a few of them. Some small, some very major. Now the first one I want to go into, and I know what you're all going to say, yes, it is the rod bearings. Now the rod bearings on these car out the factory are near enough trash. They used a terrible material, and basically the metal is just very weak. So a lot of people change them out for the ACL rod bearings. That's what this car has. And if you are buying one, make sure the rod bearings have been done with proof of a receipt, because anybody can say they have been done, but it is a preventative fault on these cars. Now you need to do it. Every single one of them is going to need to have it done. If you haven't had it done, you will need to, because if you don't, you'll need to put a new engine in the car. No one wants to do that, because these engines are very expensive. You're looking at about £7,000 to £8,000. So if you don't want to be spending that much money, you want to spend a lot less than that to save it, get the rod bearings done as soon as you can. Now, if you're one of them people that money isn't an issue and you can spend around £25,000 to £30,000 on an E90 XM3, chances are it's going to be a low mileage example. And if it's anywhere between 0 and 40,000 miles, I would say you probably don't need to get them done just yet. If you're at about 60,000 plus, I would definitely say get them done. Now, the next one I want to mention is sensors on the car. Now, this all goes through maintenance, essentially. These cars have a massive engine, and with that big engine becomes bigger problems and a lot more sensors. This car has a million sensors under the hood, so you're gonna wanna get them changed whenever one of them goes. For example, this one has an intermittent engine fault. Now, I've seen a lot of people have this same fault where it reduces the power, and it could be something as simple as a sensor. Now, you don't actually know what sensor it is until you plug it in. Now, I stressed out as soon as I seen the engine fault pop up. However, when I plugged it in, it basically just told me it was a sensor. However, if you have a normal code reader that you just plug in, a handheld one, it will tell you exactly what the fault is, but not where to go to. I would definitely recommend going to BMW to get it checked, because they have a system called ISTA, which is Integrated Service Technical Application and Programming. And that will tell you exactly what is wrong with the car, and you don't want to be taking any risks on a car like this. And they will code it out, program it, do all the necessary steps to get that sorted for you that a code reader won't be able to do. Chances are it is a sensor, because again, they have lots of them, but I would definitely recommend going to BMW to getting that checked out, just in case it is something major. Now, why I would recommend going to a dealer is I have a code reader at home, and I plugged this car in as soon as that came up, and it essentially told me it was a camshaft sensor. So I thought, okay, I'll Google camshaft sensor, perfect, I can order one. But I didn't order one just yet. I wanted to plug it in at BMW just to be safe, to make sure it actually is the camshaft sensor. And it was. However, there is six of them in this car, and it doesn't tell you which one it is. So I would definitely recommend taking it to a dealer, because you could be just chasing your tail, buying random sensors, buying the wrong ones, when you could just know exactly which one it is straight away. I feel like we talk about under this bonnet way too much on this car. But as well as the engine and the rod bearings, the other major fault that you need to get done is the throttle actuators. And everyone knows this, you know, rod bearings and throttle actuators are the main issues with these cars, and you need to get them done. Unfortunately, yes, they are expensive. They are the two most expensive things you will do on this car, but you need to get them done. So yeah, the throttle actuators are a key thing, a preventative thing to stop this engine essentially dying on you. Throttle actuators are a common thing on these cars. It'll basically just throw up a bunch of faults on your dashboard, drivetrain, engine power loss, and it will limp mode it, and you cannot go anywhere. As soon as you hit the throttle, it will just rev and drop, rev and drop, and it won't go past a certain rev. And that is because the throttle actuators basically tell the car how much throttle it gets. And if they're not working properly, your car will not drive correctly. So you definitely need to get them done, because you are just damaging the car if you leave it like that. So yeah, throttle actuators, you need to get them done. The next one I want to mention is gaskets. Now, this one does have a slight weeping oil leak, you could say, from the rocker cover gasket, because it was obviously fitted wrong, even though I've got an invoice of it being done. So that will need to be changed. And other things on the car, even as much as the gearbox and the diff, sometimes they will leak. I have a slight leak from the gearbox, but they just need gasket. So I'll definitely check them as soon as you can. And if they are leaking or there's anything wrong with it, just change them as soon as you can. It is just basic maintenance for these cars. And that is a key factor. Just keep up with the maintenance. Make sure you're checking everything where you can. If you can get it on a ramp somewhere, get it on, have a look underneath, make sure nothing is leaking. And if it is, get it sorted as soon as you can, because you're just gonna avoid other faults on this car. You're gonna save it for future. So check all your gaskets when you get the chance to. And the last one that I wanna mention, which is a common fault on a lot of them, and not all of them, especially the low mileage ones, but the higher mileage ones will have this issue. And that is bushings on the rear subframe and anything around suspension, mainly the subframe, because these cars are relatively old now. This is 2010, so it is 14 to 15 years old now, and they're getting on. It started in 07, so bushings are gonna go. This is just normal for older cars, so I would definitely recommend getting them changed. You don't wanna cause any further damage, and if a bush was to go, you will know about it, because it will knock like hell on the rear or wherever it has gone. So that is going to be A, dangerous, and two, very, very annoying. So get your bushes checked again. If you can get it on a ramp, perfect. It's going to be hard to tell that when you buy the car, for example. You might be able to look underneath it slightly with a camera or a mirror, but if you can't, get it on a ramp as soon as you can and check all the bushings. They're not too expensive, however, it is something that you probably have to do on a higher mileage one. And it's a bit annoying, I know, but if you want the car to drive as well as it should, you need to get the bushings changed. So that is going to wrap up today's video, and I hope it does help you. I hope this gave you an idea of what these cars need and what you need to do in order to save yourself plenty of money. But that is going to be it for today. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.